Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we will see how to work using the 3D gizmos, that is 3D rotate, 3D scale and 3D move and 3D array commands in AutoCAD. So let's see. Now we'll see how to work in AutoCAD 3D using different types of gizmos, that is move, rotate and scale and 3D array command. So let's go in AutoCAD. We'll just click on the start drawing. But here we'll be using the AutoCAD 3D template. I'll just click on open. I'll just go and change the view to 2D wireframe. Here I'll just create one rectangular box. So I'll just create one rectangle. We'll use the extrude command to give the height. Now we'll see different types of gizmo command. So basically there are three types of gizmo command, that is move, scale and rotate. First we'll see move gizmo. So for that we have to go here in the modify. Here we can see the option, that is 3D move. So I'll just select this, select the object, press enter. Now it is asking to specify the base point. I'll just select the base point and simply we can move the object. We can also specify the distance. I'll just again select this base point. Suppose I want to move in the backward direction, so I'll just make the ortho command on first. I'll just specify the distance, say as 200. We'll get move at a distance of 200 from the base point selected. Next we'll see rotate. So basically you will also get the options from here, or from here also you can work, and the other options are in the application status bar. See, move gizmo, rotate and scale gizmo. So I'll just use from here, or you can just type in the command manager, that is 3D rotate. See, you can also get the option. Now I'll select the object to rotate. So just select, press enter. Now here you can see there are three axes, that is three circles. One is in the green color, second is the red color, and third is in the orange color. So using that we can rotate the object. Suppose I will just select this line. Here we can rotate the object giving the angle. Suppose I am giving the angle of 45. See, like this I can rotate the angle, that is the object. Again we will see 3D rotate and rotate in the different direction. So now I will be using this axis. We will specify the angle as 150. See, now it got rotated at an angle of 150. Suppose I want to rotate in other direction, so I'll just again select the object. I'll just select this. I will give the angle of 180. It got rotated in the same position, so we'll again select. Now I'll select this axis. Suppose I am selecting this blue axis. Now again I am giving the angle of 50. So like this we can rotate the object using the 3D gizmo command, that is 3D rotate gizmo command. Next we will see the scale. For that I will just using this 3D scale option. Select the object, press enter. It is asking to specify the base point. So just specify the base point. Now it is asking to pick a scale axis. So I'll just select this point. Here it is not taking the plane. So I'll just create one new tab. I'll just create one box. you just make it in the wireframe. We'll go in the 3D scale, select the object, press enter, we specify the base point. See, you can see here there are 3 points. So using that, we can simply scale the object. See, you can just specify the scale factor. Suppose I want it 3 times, I'll just specify the scale factor as 3 and press enter. See, the object got scaled to 3 times of the original object. So like this, we can use the 3D scale gizmo. Now we'll skip how to use the 3D array command. So basically in 3D array, there are two types, rectangular and polar. So first we'll see rectangular. So I'll just use this object for the 3D array. For that, just enter 3D array, press enter. It is asking to select the object. So I'll just select this object, press enter. I'll select the first option, that is rectangular. Now here it is asking for the enter number of rows. Suppose I will just enter the number of rows as 6, and same for the column. It is asking for the number of levels, that is in Z direction. So I'll take it as 3. Now it is asking to specify the distance between the objects. So I'll just take the distance of 200. In column distance also 200, and levels also of 200. See, now you can see the number of levels are 3. I'll just make the front view. You can see the number of levels are 3, number of rows are 6. I'll just show you the side view. See, here also you can get the number of columns are 6. So like this, we can use the 3D array command, that is rectangular 3D, and create this 3D polar. Now we'll see how to use the polar option. So I'll just click on the new tab. Now suppose I will just draw one circle here. I'll just extrude this circle up to certain height. I'll just select the wireframe view. Now here I have to specify one axis around which I want to rotate this, that is 3D polar. So I'll just make ortho command on first. I'll just draw one axis around which I will rotate this. I'll use the 3D array command. Select the object, press enter. Now here we'll be using the second option, that is polar. It is asking to specify the number of items. Suppose I will take total number of items as 6. It is asking me to specify the angle. So we'll take the angle of 360. Now here we have to press yes. Now it is asking to specify the center point of the array. So I'll just select this as a center point. And now it is asking to specify the second point. So I'll just specify this as my second point. See. Now you can see this had got array in the polar manner using the 360 angle around this axis. So like this, we can use the 3D polar array command in AutoCAD. Thank you friends for watching this video.